What is everyone saying? Hope you're all doing good. And today I'm going to be taking you through a coat haul slash try on and review. It's basically Moncler or Canada Goose. Are they worth the money that you spend on them? Let's get into it. Just before I get into this video, two of these coats I got one Moncler and one Canada Goose. Canada Goose I've had for like over a year now, so obviously it's going to be worn compared to the Moncler, which I've recently got. You can get multiple types of obviously these coats, but I'm just going for the only two I've got. Okay, so firstly, we'll start off with the Canada Goose. As you can see, it is very worn. It's a camo colour. You got the Canada Goose here. Got a little patch here as well. This is my first designer coat. But it's survived a long time. I had it nearly 2 years or something like that, but it's a nice parka. As you can see, got the wolf hair. I think it's fitted with it as well, inside obviously. But very nice. Kept me warm. I think I got this in Dubai when I went to Dubai a while back. I was looking for just the normal plain black one, and I saw this. It's got the Canada Goose there on the zip tag. Nice, as you can see, buttons as well. So from the back, it's just a plain, but it is also a camo colour. Has a few pockets inside as well. One here, hide whatever you want to hide. I think that's it in terms of pockets, but it's got as you can see, straps here if you wanted to tighten it around the waist. Tightens it there. Washing it, that no one really cares about. But I think the price for this was, I don't actually remember. I'll put it on screen anyway. But again, I don't know if they've discontinued this because it is pretty old. It is really old. As you can see again, like, it is a discontinued item. I'm not too sure, I'll double check that. But, and again, this fur here, it's really, really, it'll keep you warm. It's really nice. I think there are fake bits in here as well, in terms of the fur. But again, I'm not complaining. If you didn't want that, you can as well. It's got a zip, so you can zip the hood. Take it off or keep it on. I like it on, just because that's what a parka is. So I can put the price for this on, obviously, on the screen for you. So the coats that I've had, this coat and this coat are similar in price as well. It's not just two really expensive coats, but again, let me know the thoughts on this. Canada Goose. Button down camouflage parka. Very, very nice. First ever designer Canada Goose. Canada coat, sorry, for me. On to my favourite out of, I don't know if you caught a glimpse of that. This is my favourite one to date in terms of a designer coat, and that is Moncler X Valentino. It's got the Moncler tag right there. With a Valentino underlaid, if you can see that. Really nice. It is a, I think it's a, it's like a Gioche puffer. Obviously this isn't your typical Moncler because it's a collab with Valentino. As you can see, the massive V. I got this for my birthday off my GF. So, Again, very pricey. I've not yet worn it because I don't really know where I've wore it, where it because of lockdown and stuff. But I'll show you what it looks like on. There'll only be a certain amount of places you can wear this. I've worn it to try it on, obviously, but it's so nice. As you can see, when you're putting it up, it has the Valentino on the front. The Moncler on the side. People say it looks like a bin bag, but I think I rock a bin bag pretty well, to be fair. Like, it's a very standout coat. You'll know exactly. If you saw someone in this, you know it's worth a bit of money, as you can see. Really nice. Sleeves feel a bit short, as you can see, but again, no one's really going to be going like that, are they? But again, as you can see, normally, maybe I'll just put a bit of weight on. Valentino looks so nice. I'll show you the insides. It's got a double zip, which is what you need. Has every Moncler comes with this like comic book type, as you can see. It's supposed to be a pocket or something inside here. I'm not too sure, I'm not going to mess with it, but still got the tag on with the Moncler tag. Just because I've not worn it anywhere, so I don't really want to take it off. The Moncler X Valentino on the backboard of the coat. And then the typical three colours, the blue, white and red. Would I spend money on this coat? Personally, yes, if I was rinsing however much. I'll put it on screen however much it was, because it was a present, so. Again, Moncler X Valentino. Hood. It's a bit thinner than the parka, but it is a bubble coat, so it is expected. Like, there's no fur on the both sides. Other than that, I think that's it. Again, see what it looks like on. This looks so nice. I can't wait to be out of lockdown and be wearing this all the time. Don't want to overuse it though. I think you just won't like it. But as you can see, the quality is really good. Well, it's expected for however much this coat is. But yeah. What do you guys think of it? Would you rock it, or is it a bit too out there for you guys? Also comes with, not that anybody really cares, but it came in a dust bag with massive Moncler on it. But yeah. Tell me what you guys thought of that, or them two. Which one would you have between the two? So, would you have the Moncler that I've got in this hand, or the Canada Goose? Personally, I'd get them both, just in terms of, because you wouldn't wear, like, you wouldn't wear this on a walk out, like a long, long walk. For this, it'll probably keep you more warm. This is more about the fashion. So if you did enjoy the video, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe. If you are new, let me know in the comments down below which coat you prefer, the Canada Goose or the Moncler. And prices will have been on screen. Again, this video is more of just an instructive if you would like to buy them, more of like for me. Because I've got them, I'm not going to go out of my way to spend half much money on a coat just because I don't like it. It's more of just like informative. So if you guys are wanting to buy a really expensive designer coat or anything, like, these are the reasons why I think they're worth the money, if that makes sense. Anyway, so yeah, like I said, if you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe if you want, and I'll see you in the next one. Pass me the Rizla, half of a fag. My weed over there in the bag. Take two toes and give me that back. You don't give me no cash, don't give me that crap. Call it a cab, before I get mad.